Welcome to your channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. I'm your host, Dr. Ghosh, and I'm delighted to host you with another awe-inspiring story for all of you. Friends, mankind is facing its biggest battle against the infamous COVID-19 virus. And we have to learn some critical lessons if we have to come out as winners against this infamous virus. Before we go on to that, for those of you who are already my subscribers, a heartfelt thank you to each one of you. And for those of you who are coming on to the first time to the channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant, let me share with you a brief history of the channel. Generous, Gracious and Gallant was formed in 2015, and today on Facebook we have got about 810 subscribers. On WhatsApp we have got 120 plus subscribers, and we started the channel Generous, Gracious and Gallant on YouTube in May 2020, and there we have got about 150 subscribers as on date. The channel Generous, Gracious and Gallant was started with twin objectives. One is to share daily inspiration with you, and number two, to share the stories of mankind at its very best. This is to enhance the moral fiber of the present and coming generations, and also enable you to put your best foot forward in all circumstances. So could I request that all of you please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so that you will be updated every time I come out with a new video with another awe-inspiring story for all of you. Coming back to our story, the year was 1935, and it was a cold evening, and an old lady was brought to the court, night court. The old lady was wearing tattered clothes, and she looked very unhappy and sad. And behind the sadness, you could also make out she was shameful that she had been brought to court for having stolen a loaf of bread. That particular evening, the judge on duty was Fiorello LaGuardia, the mayor of New York City. Fiorello was the 99th mayor of New York City, and he served three terms from 1934 to 1945. He was all of 5 feet 2 inches tall, and therefore called as Little Flower or Fiorello, but the name belied his toughness. He was known as a reform mayor. He cleaned up corruption. He was very tough on gangsters and was able to successfully arrest many gangsters and crime lords, and brought in experts and was able to clean up the city. He also, for all his toughness, was a generous, kind-hearted man who believed in the interconnectedness of mankind. This interconnectedness of mankind is what is the lesson we have to learn in these critical COVID-19 times. He asked the old lady wearing tattered clothes, sitting in the courtroom, "Did you steal the loaf of bread?" The woman replied by lowering her head and said, "That's right, Your Honor, I did steal the loaf of bread." Fiorello LaGuardia again asked her a second question. "What was your motive for stealing?" Were you hungry? The old woman, looking at the judge, replied, Yes, I was hungry, but I didn't steal the bread for myself. My son-in-law abandoned his family. My daughter is very sick and she has two children. They are hungry. They have not eaten for many days. I could not stand to see them hungry. They are so young. On hearing this, the courtroom fell silent. You could hear pin drop silence. Looking at the woman, LaGuardia said, Everyone is equal under the law. So you have to pay a fine of $10 or go to prison for 10 days. The woman replied, Judge, I am willing to be punished for what I have done, but respectfully, if I had $10, why would I have stolen the bread? I am willing to go to jail. My only concern is what will happen to my sick daughter and my grandchildren. Who will look after them when I am in jail? The judge, Ferrelio LaGuardia, who was a humanitarian with a heart of gold, leant back on his chair, put his hand inside his jacket, took out a $10 note and showed it so the whole court could have a look at it, and said, With this $10, I pay for your punishment. You are free to go. And then he turned to the audience in the courtroom and he said, In addition, I charge every person in the courtroom 50 cents as penalty for the indifference and ignorance in this community. An old woman should not have to steal bread to feed her family. He ordered the bailiff, Mr. Bailiff, collect money from everyone and give it to the accused old lady. Everyone there contributed 50 cents. Among them, 50 cents also was contributed by police officers and the owner of the bakery from whom the old lady had stolen the loaf of bread. The next day, this incident came out in New York newspapers and it was reported that a collection of $47.50 was made and handed over to the old lady. The point is, mankind has become too complacent to the suffering of other people. We are all interconnected with each other. When one suffers, we all will suffer. We need to stand up and look after each other. The message rippled through the city. No man is an island. We are all interconnected. It is very easy to pay attention to the well-being of ourselves and only our family and look after our material benefits. But it takes a true humanitarian and human being to pay attention to the needs of others and understand their pain and suffering. Mark Twain, the famous American author, once said, Goodness is the language that the deaf can hear and the blind can see. This story, my friends, is very relevant in today's COVID-19 times. We all have to understand that many, many people have got affected with this COVID-19 virus and have paid for it with their lives and their livelihoods. Mass immigration is going on across the world in search of food and opportunities. Those of you who have been lucky enough not to be affected so much by the COVID-19 virus need to stand up, show your solidarity with mankind, be counted and make a difference. Not all of us can afford to make a difference to multiple people, but yes, all of us can stand up, be counted and make a difference to one person. That's all it takes. Make a difference to one. You never know where the ripples of your kindness will spread out and the effects the ripples of your kindness will have on the recipient of your kindness and his family. COVID-19 requires that you stand up, be counted, understand that we are all interconnected. When one person suffers, we all suffer. No man is an island, and kindness is the language we all have to speak. The language of kindness is what will make mankind win the battle against the infamous COVID-19 virus. Let me also add, in these times, I request you to please wear a mask at all times when you're going out of your residence, maintain social distancing, and help curtail the spread of the COVID-19 virus. Remember, stand up, be counted against the battle of the COVID-19 virus. Till we meet again with another awe-inspiring story on your channel, Generous, Gracious and Gallant. Good luck, all the best, stay safe.